Hello, my name is Keshwani.
That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I,
Keshwani. We are here because we want to prepare for the HESI. Today is our lesson number 3 in our vocabulary series. We've been doing vocabulary words out of this book here, the HESI Admission Assessment Exam Review, the 3rd edition. If you do not own this book already, purchase one immediately. You're going to need it. Right now, we are in chapter number 3. Chapter number 3 on page 48. We're going to pick up from where we left off yesterday. Word number 11. If you happen to need help with the math problem in this book, you will find all the math problem being solved. We have finished series in the math from day number 1 through 50. They are all there. Just type in HESI math day 1. By the way, the math on the HESI is very similar to what you will find on TEES, and there are 80 videos there if you wish to avail yourself. The very first word that we're going to come across here is a very simple word, very straightforward word. The word is annual, which simply means occurring once a year. Once a year. Your annual bonus is so-called because you get it once a year. Annual holiday is a holiday that you get once a year, whatever the holiday may be. That was a silly example, actually. What do we call something that happens twice a year? Something that happens twice a year is said to be biannual. Biannual, which means happens twice a year. Happens twice a year. Biannual. What do we call something that happens once every 2 years? Happens not twice a year, but once every 2 years. Happens once every 2 years, or if you like, happens every other year. Something that happens every other year, something that happens once every 2 years, or what do we call such an event? Such an event is said to be biannual and biannual. Don't confuse the two. They sound a little bit alike, but they're not actually alike at all if you pay close attention. Biannual is this word, which means it happens twice a year. Biannual, let's put down the pronunciation. Bi, just like before, bi means two. Annual. You see the difference? Biannual simply means biannual is just a very fancy way of saying it happens every other year. It happens every other year. It happens once every 2 years. What do we call something that happens once every 2 weeks? Happens once every 2 weeks, or happens every other week. Happens every other week. This is where things get tricky. This is where things get prickly, because a typical term that people use, especially in the US, to describe something that happens once every 2 years, every 2 weeks, listen carefully, the typical term that the people use to describe something that happens every 2 weeks, every other week, the typical term that people use in the US particularly, is actually not the correct term, but that is the term that they use, and it's the term that has stuck, so that's what we use here, but it's not correct term. Let's learn the proper term and the term that most people actually use in their speech and even in the writing. The correct term, something that happens every 2 weeks, every other week is called, something that happens every other week is called fortnight is the noun. Fortnight is the noun, which simply means period of 2 weeks. Period of 2 weeks is called a fortnight. So if it happens once every 2 weeks, you said that it occurs fortnightly. The adverb would be fortnightly. I get paid fortnightly. I get paid fortnightly, meaning that I get paid every other week. They don't pay me every week. I don't get paid every Friday. I get paid fortnightly. Instead, people don't say fortnightly. They say bi-weekly. Bi-weekly. Bi-weekly, to me, sounds like it happens twice a week. That's not what they mean. When they say bi-weekly, bi-weekly has come to mean, bi-weekly has by now come to mean, it happens every other week. But the actual term, the proper term, is fortnightly. It happens every fortnight. It happens every fortnight. Let's learn the next word. A period of 10 years. A period of 10 years is called a decade, of course. A period of 10 years. A period of 10 years. What is a period of 20 years called? Do you know? Of course, we know period of 100 years. Period of 100 years is called a century. Period of 1,000 years is called a millennium. What is a period of 20 years called? Do you know? A period of 20 years is called a score. A score is 20. A period of just, it could mean just 20, it could mean 20, or a period of 20 years. Period of 20 years. For the Americans, they might recall a lanky fellow flapping his gums on top of the hill, going on and on about something that happened 4 score and 7 years ago. Like I said, this particular lanky fellow, if you recall, was flapping his gums on the top of the hill, going on and on about something that happened to occur 4 score and 7 years ago. Well, 4 score and 7 years would be 4 times 20 plus 7. 4 times 20 plus 7 is 87. Something that happened 87 years ago, if you add 1776 to it, you get 13, carry 1, you get 6, carry 1, you get 8. It seems to me that he must have been yapping in year 1863. In 1863 must have been the year when he was yapping about something that happened, something that occurred 4 score and 7 years ago. But as I said, it does not need to be a period of 20 years. It does not need to be a period of 20 years. It could also simply mean 20, just 20. That's all it is. Scores of people came to hear him sing. Scores of people came to hear him sing. Scores of people
came to see his paintings.
Well, that's just a very polite way of saying that not too many people came. Because not too many people came because we are not even at liberty to say hundreds of people came. Fewer than 100 people must have come, because otherwise, if it had been 200 or 300 or 400 people, you would have been at liberty to say, use the term hundreds of people came, let alone thousands of people. It wasn't even hundreds of people. It was just a few people, few dozen people. But if you just say a few dozen people came to see his painting, that doesn't sound as good. So to give it more of a panache to the phrase, instead of saying just few dozen people came, you say scores of people came to see his paintings. Now all of a sudden it sounds pretty impressive. Scores of people came to see his paintings. Scores of people were duped by him. Scores of people were duped by him, were tricked by him. Which just means some multiple of 20, maybe 40, 60, 80, something like that. Not a large number. I'll see you tomorrow, okay? Bye now.